Hi, this is CBRadioMagazine.com, and today I want to show you guys the UR6QW 8-band equalizer, compressor, noise gate, and echo processor. This is a neat little device because it offers you a lot of features you wouldn't have on a standard CB radio or export radio. These are features that are often on more expensive ham radios, but this inline device offers you these features to add to your radio at a price at around $130 to $150. This is an inline device, which means that it goes in between your microphone and your radio. You'd plug your microphone in here, and then there's an output that runs up to your radio up here. They custom wired this for me. This is available on eBay. You can tell them what kind of wiring you want. There are ones that are already pre-wired for Cobra or RCI or ICOM Yaesu. The device has a power connector on the back, and I'll show you that. And it takes 12 volt power. It doesn't come with a power cord. I actually had to take this from something else and repurpose it. So you plug in your power here. I have that going out to my 12 volt DC supply. This is your output cable. And I will say, I'm really impressed with the device. The only thing I wasn't impressed with was the cable coming out. It's kind of like heat shrink tubing. Could be a little more robust, but other than that, I really didn't have any complaints on the construction of the device. So what does this do? It offers you 8 bands of equalization. So you have low end, mid range, and high range. It has a speech compressor here, it has a microphone gain here, noise gate control, attack time here, echo, delay, and output. And I'll kind of explain which each one of these do. So the equalizer offers you the ability to change the tone, basically the frequency response. There used to be a couple microphones, CB microphones, that offered this feature on the microphone for tone control. Pretty basic though, it's kind of like high and low. This offers you the full range, so you can adjust your low end, your mid range, or your high end. This will definitely change a little bit of how you sound on the air. It's not like a voice changing feature, this is just kind of adjusting your frequency response here for the tone of your voice going through the box. However, adjusting some of these things in certain ways can make you a little more punchy on the air, which definitely is useful when you're talking DX, especially, you know, some of the high end here. These guys do include a whole manual, and it's great because they do have different settings they show you here, saying if you're going to talk, you know, DX, set it to this setup, and you can see here on the high end they've got it pretty high up. The device does have an overload LED that turns blue, and this lets you know when you're basically overloading the audio going into the device, and so you can see that there. The compressor, it has a 1-to-1 up to 6-to-1 compression ratio. If you've never worked or learned about compression in speech compression, basically it increases your talk power, and I'll show a waveform up on the screen here, and it basically is going to offer you the ability to increase your dB levels, which is going to make you sound louder on the air to other stations. It'll help increase your average talk power, and that's something that's pretty important when you're on the air, and especially when you're trying to talk DX. Now this ratio, you can adjust this, you know, where your needs are. If you try and do too much compression, you can get some distortion. There are also some videos by UR6QW showing a little bit of this on a waveform, which he's using, and you can definitely see the waveform bump up, and it basically increases the waveform. You'll see it expand a little bit, which is increasing your talk power. Microphone gain control here. This thing really will boost your audio, so you don't need to add a huge amount of mic gain. Your noise gate will adjust the amount of background noise down, and this actually works really well. It was kind of interesting. I messed around with it with some headphones on, running some fans, and you can hear, you know, the fan noise, and as I turn the noise gate up, the fan noise starts to get softer and softer, and then eventually disappears and almost sounds kind of like dead air in between when I was talking. So neat feature there for getting rid of background noise. This is your attack time, and this controls the basically the fade in when you're using the noise gate. So this will control normal, fast, or slow, how quickly or slowly that fade in happens when your audio kicks in when you have the noise gate enabled. Next is your echo. This controls the amount of echo, and then the delay, the length of the delay. Echo's pretty clean and good on this device. I will say I've heard a little bit better through that turbo echo board you used to be able to get from RF Limited, but this is actually pretty good and clean, not a whole lot of distortion on it. This is your master output, which is kind of like a master output you'd have on a mixing board. So your mic gain is controlling, you know, the amount of gain you're adding, but this is the master control out for everything. So with buying this device, you're getting a full equalizer, speech compressor, you're getting control of your gain, basically like adding a power microphone, even just using a stock mic. You get the noise gate to reduce background noise. You get a echo control. It's very cool for everything that it adds. You can use this with basically a stock microphone and sound like you're using a really high quality microphone. All right, I promised you guys a peek inside. I got the case screws out. The whole bottom case just comes off. This is the top piece flipped upside down. You can see the microphone connector input is here. Here's the pass through for like the up down channel, stuff like that, that isn't going to be affected by the processor. The audio gets fed in here, and you can see it comes back out over here and then goes back on the output. This is your chip, this is your circuit board. You got your chips in here. And then these are all your potentiometers underneath here to control your different levels. This is your power input on the backside here.